What's going on, guys? My name is Eric, and this is First Thing in the Morning's Q&A Day 2. Now, today is very, very special Q&A, because I got tons of questions. You guys were awesome this time. Like, I thought I got a lot last time. I got even more this time. But there's one very, very special person to me that leaps and bounds above everybody else. That's not to say that I don't appreciate the rest of you, but you really, really put in some effort, got me some great questions this time. That's right, today, all my questions are from Social Media Wife. Who's Social Media Wife, you might be asking yourself? That's simple. Social Media Wife is at its mother, Kay. She's a great girl. I absolutely adore her. And even though she's a Boston Bruins fan, and I'm a Montreal Canadiens fan, still get along. My God, we're a veritable modern-day Romeo and Juliet. On with the questions, and Heisenberg decided to join me. She asks, how would you book Seth Rollins' return to the ring? Geez, that's a really good question. What I would do is definitely bring him back as a top babyface. Now, if you remember the Triple H's 2002 return, the pop he got, I honestly believe that Rollins is going to get the same kind of reception when he finally makes his way back, which I've heard on those dirty dirt sheets that it should be around May, June when he's returned. I'd like to see him get right back into the world heavyweight title picture, because technically he never lost that title. So I think booking him right back in, he makes a monstrous comeback and he's right back into a main program for the title. I think that would be great. Even if he doesn't necessarily go over right away, I think putting him back into that main title picture is best for business. All right, up next she asked, if you could pick a new Raw general manager with the authority disbanded, who would it be? Simple. Right off the top of my head, I didn't even think about this question for 2 seconds, I'd bring back Daniel Bryan. The reason being is I love Daniel Bryan, and I'm pretty sure everybody else does too. I think he'd be great. I mean, you know, he's obviously a good guy. People love him, so he can give the people what they want, at the same time kind of messing with the heels, and it would be a nice change of pace. I know we have Shane now, who's kind of like the babyface authority figure, but I don't see Shane sticking around long term. So maybe when he leaves, you could bring in Daniel Bryan, and trust me, just trust me on this one, people would go nuts. I mean, seeing him on Total Bellas isn't enough. People want to see Daniel Bryan in an arena, and if we can't see him wrestle, let's see how he does making a couple wrestling matches. So that's my pick. If the authority was disbanded today and I was in charge, I'd give Daniel Bryan a call and say, hey, come back to work. Now, this next question I really like because it gives me an opportunity to do a little fantasy booking. If there's one thing that wrestling fans love doing more than complaining on Twitter, it's fantasy booking. So let's get right into it. Is turning Roman Reigns best for business, or should the WWE stay the course? Well, you can take a vacation on this one, Brain, because I don't need you. Yes, they should definitely turn Roman Reigns heel. Now, if you listen to those crowd reactions, one could argue that he already is. But I think WWE has taken this one step further recently with his new catchphrase, I'm not a good guy, I'm not a bad guy, I'm the guy. Now that is not a babyface promo. That is a heel promo if I've ever heard one. So how would I continue this? How would I make sure that Roman goes full heel? That's simple. At Payback, you got Roman Reigns versus AJ Styles for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. Now at some point during the match, I'd have Anderson and Gallows come down to the ring just staring a hole through Roman Reigns. I'm talking tractor beam, like right in there. They never take their eyes off him. Now AJ gets the upper hand in the match, and it looks like he just might pull it off and win the title until Anderson and Gallows jump in the ring and attack him, causing the disqualification. AJ wins, but Roman retains. Now the cherry on the sundae, if you will, would be the next night on Raw, when all the lights go out and all of a sudden the Bullet Club logo pops up, Roman Reigns comes out flanked by Anderson and Gallows, and that's right, Roman Reigns is the new leader of the Bullet Club. And watch the internet kill itself if this would ever happen. Now, I don't think it would happen, But that's what I would like to see, and it'd be one hell of a way to get heat on Roman. All right, now this next question is awesome. I like the last one, but I think this one is even better. Is there any hope in making the U.S. title relevant again besides throwing it on Cena and restarting the Open Challenge? 100% absolutely yes. There is still plenty of time to save the U.S. title, rebuild it, and make it mean something again. Surprise cameo. What I would do, though, is I would instigate another brand split. Have Raw and SmackDown be two separate entities with their own rosters. No trading in between. Raw is something, SmackDown is something. Now, I'd keep the IC title on Raw, but I would bring the US title and make it SmackDown exclusive. Another thing I would do with the title is that every week, the title would be defended. So that way, not only are you building up your title, not only are you building up its prestige, but you're also building up the champion. Now, if a guy has a 6-month reign, but he defends it every week, you can call that a fighting champion. Oh, Eric, but wait a minute, what if he's a heel? Then you make him cheat every week. They have the talent to do it. They have tons of talent. They have so much talent, they could easily fill both shows. And that would also limit fatigue on us, on the viewers, of always seeing the same people come out every week. I think a brand split, making the title defended every single week, and then not hot-shotting it. That would be the last thing. Not hot-shotting, not playing hot potato, you know? Here, you have your week with the title, then he has his week, and then that guy will have his week, and then Fred in accounting will have his week too. No. Put it on a guy, keep it on him for a while, let the title gain prestige by being defended every single week successfully, build up the guy by having him successfully defend the title, and there you go. Voila, your title means something again. Okay, her next question is, will Enzo and Cass have longevity on the main roster, or will they fizzle out? I don't think anybody has to worry about Enzo and Cass going anywhere. If you judge the reaction they get since they've made their debut, it's been almost deafening. I mean, just look at this past week in London. I think there was the New Day at the top, and then AJ Styles, and then Enzo. People love doing the entrance with Enzo. Their entrance is kind of a throwback to the New Age Outlaws. People loved it when they came out back in the Attitude Era, and I think we have the equivalent here with Enzo and Cass, so no, I don't see Enzo and Cass going anywhere. In fact, I'll make a bold prediction. I think they're going to win the tag team tournament and face the New Day for the WWE tag team titles. Social media wife on an absolute roll, so we're going to keep on going here. Should superstars have more opportunities to show their character ideas on TV in time to get them over like the New Day has had? 100%. I think it's a great idea to let the guys you've hired to be entertaining be themselves, because there is nothing more entertaining than when a guy is just comfortable with his character, because that character is an extension of himself. You need proof? Go back to the Attitude Era. Did anybody give a shit about the ringmaster? No. Then he put on a pair of black boots, black trunks, and he started being himself, and he became Stone Cold Steve Austin, and the rest is history. Let me ask you another question. Did anybody give two shits about Rocky Maivia? No. In fact, they chanted "Die Rocky, die" at the guy. So what happened? WWE let him go. He turned himself into The Rock, and he became one of the most popular personas in wrestling. And not only in wrestling, but he made a successful jump to Hollywood, which I think he's the first guy to ever do. So yes, I think WWE should stop trying to shoehorn these poor guys into gimmicks that don't suit him. Roman Reigns. And they should just let them be themselves, because when you're yourself, it's genuine, and when it's genuine, the fans connect with it. Alright, so to end today's Q&A, we're going to go out with a video game question. So, she wants to know who my favorite female video game character is. Now, this took me a while to figure it out, because I wanted to try and think of a positive role model for girls inside a video game, and in a world where video games are mostly played by men, meaning that most of the female characters have gigantic tits that are spilling out of their top and like the perfect body, it was actually a pretty difficult question to come up with a decent answer for, but I got one. Aya from the game Parasite Eve, which was a PlayStation 1 RPG kind of slash survival horror. If you haven't played it, definitely check it out. It's one of my favorite games of all time. The cool thing about Aya is that she is just a normal looking girl. She's a girl that you could walk by on the street and not even think twice about it. But in the context of the game, she kicks just as much ass, if not more, than the men. And actually, a special shout out for Parasite Eve, because the main villain is also female. So someone at Square Enix took some feminism classes and they put them all into Parasite Eve. Really wish they would make a sequel. So yeah, Aya from Parasite Eve is my favorite female video game character. All right, guys, that was First Thing in the Morning's Q&A Day 2. Thank you very much for Kristen, who provided all these awesome questions. I had a great time answering them, and I hope my answers satisfied you. Nothing but love for you. Go follow her on Twitter, at itsmotherK. Now, if you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter and on Instagram at MTLBroski for all the latest First Thing in the Morning news. Go check out the Facebook fan page at facebook.com/FTITM. And as always, be good to each other. Don't be assholes online when you're gaming. And come back tomorrow for part 3 of First Thing in the Morning's Q&A.